Hi, everyone. Thanks a lot for having me tonight here on TED. And my name is Bachir, but most people know me as Athene for breaking world records in gaming and for my mathematical way of solving problems when it comes to games. And the thing is that we've raised about more than $11 million now the past 2 years. And I've been getting a lot of media attention from CNN to Fox News to Bloomberg TV. And also lately here also in Belgian media. And the thing is that I have to give credit to the gaming community and companies such as Razer for being able to achieve this great goal, because we have managed to reach more than 1 million children worldwide and lowering child mortality. And tonight I'm here to talk about something really crazy. I'm going to try and answer or give an answer to mankind's biggest question, and it is, why are we here? And I don't have a science degree, but I do read a lot of Reddit and Wikipedia, so I'm gonna give it a shot. When I was very young, I was always very fascinated with life. I always asked questions about why I'm here. What is this consciousness? What is life? And I was always extremely fascinated with science. And I don't know if it was because my mother was Catholic and my father was Muslim, and that I, from very early, had different beliefs that that stimulated me to be, yeah, to be inspired to think about life. But I was really extremely into science, and it led me to neuroscience, because in order to understand consciousness, I had to understand how the brain worked. And I did a lot of research, I read a lot about it. And the thing is that neuroscientists say that consciousness emerges from electrical activity in our brain. And even though it doesn't sound too crazy, it actually has really crazy ramifications, because consciousness doesn't have a real center. It just emerges from all the neural networks within your brain. So to give an example, if you want to eat, it's not because there's a part in your brain telling you you have to eat now. Like, it's not, there is no pilot. There is no one in the cockpit saying, like, you have to eat now, you have to sleep now. It's merely the part of the brain becoming more active. And as our will is the drive to reduce dissonance between all those neural networks, we want to eat to create resonance with that part of the brain. And the thing is that all our behavior is dictated by that. And it was very paradigm shifting for me, because since I was really young, I always got conditioned about labeling myself and believing that I am my story. But when I look at the brain and the great leaps forward that neuroscience has given us in a better understanding of consciousness, labeling ourselves and creating borders is not so much in line with what we are. And what it has done with me is it has made me realize that the environment, the people around me, are much more connected to what I am than what I thought and what I grew up with. Just to give an example, right now I'm here in the Roma talking to you guys, and if I wouldn't be here, I'd probably be doing something else. We're literally every single moment a different person, a different entity. And it really goes all the way back in time. When we look at evolution and the way we actually evolved from stardust and became self-aware through billions of years of evolution, our brain has adapted properties to be able to survive and bring us where we are right now. We populate the entire planet, and we're on the top of the food chain because evolution and the way our brain has evolved. And the thing is that we are much more connected with one another than we think. When we look, for example, at ants and we try and study them, we will see that the colony behaves in a much more complex way than the single individuals. And the thing is, we're not so much different when we look at, for example, all our neurons, hundreds of billions of them, bringing about consciousness that is much more complex than all those single neurons. In a sense, the whole is more than the sum of all the parts. And the same applies to society. When we look at society, it's much more complex, much more intelligent than all single individuals. We're, in a sense, a superorganism. And it is really amazing to me because when you look to Eastern philosophy or to even religion, the connection that we have with one another, there is science, there is more and more scientific backup that shows us the same things and tells us the same things. And the thing is, when I grew up, I was always wondering and pondering reality. And the reason why I'm putting so much time and effort in saving children's lives, I stream 16 hours a day trying to raise funds. Even though I really feel and I'm very connected with what I'm doing, the empathic part of the brain, the empathy that I have, is not enough to keep going. Because when I look at the screen, I merely just see numbers. And at one point, you just lose touch with what you're doing. And it's actually my research in science and what science has taught me that has made me keep going. Because the environment is much more connected with who we are. If we help the people around us, if we help our friends, or if we help our family, we're in a sense helping the self. And the boundary that we experience when we look around us, or the boundary that we experience when we look at ourselves, is merely a conditioning. Because when you look at it from a neuroscientific point of view, consciousness expresses itself as one entity. There is no such a thing as external when you look at it from a neuroscientific point of view. The people around you, when you talk, when you think, everything takes place in your consciousness, your memories, your feelings, your experiences. And the fact that science has taught me that has really made me more aware that by helping others, by helping your environment, by doing what evolution has evolved us to do, you're basically helping the self. And the reason why I'm here tonight is because I wanted to tell that science has really taught me that. Science has taught me morals and values, even though sometimes when we look at science, we think that it's empty, that it doesn't really give a feeling for empathy or a feeling for caring. But when we look at the evolution and the way that evolution has paved the way, then the answer to the question why we're here lies in science. And it doesn't point towards our personal differences or to where we don't agree with, but rather in a deeper understanding of the self, which points towards the stars. Thank you.